Look at who's looking absolutely similar. We have same clothes.
You're a little bit darker than I. No, oh. Same color.
Yes, yes.
Color exactly the same. That.
Oh, yeah.
Color blind says that.
But my bow tie is going to be a little different. Are you all set?
Yeah.
You look
I'm
ready?
Yeah.
I'll take not more than 5 minutes.
Just so this one is not fixed properly. But
oh, there are some experts here. See how he's doing.
This is good.
Every time I see him, handsome, handsome man. I don't even know his name. I don't know where he lives. But he's still to blame for all the misery he gives me. Because he's handsome, oh, so handsome.
Okay, the only thing I'm missing right now is my bow tie. But you look fabulous, handsome,
yeah.
All three of you.
Mm-hmm. Right, perfect groomsman.
Yep. Perfect groomsman. So, you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready. And you? What about you?
Just the bow tie missing.
Handsome man, handsome man. Who can he be? Ooh, he's just right for me.
That is the men brigade on the bright side of the family.
Oh, yeah.
So, all set?
Yes,
all set. Okay, so what all basically work there is there that we need to do?
I think placing the chair.
Placing the chairs?
And add some flower because they have no
enough. Decoration on the altar?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Because yesterday we could not do all that stuff. There were chances that it would rain all night, which thankfully it did not. And we are very lucky that there's going to be no rain today as per the current forecast.
Yeah. Looks overcast, but no rain. That's good.
Oh, I want all her innocent kisses. Oh, I want all her mystery. I want to stand by her in the moonlight.
Who was driving this car yesterday?
Rahul Gulani.
Rahul Gulani. Okay. Now, as you can see, we are putting the seats together and we are figuring out how many should be in one because we need to reduce the number of aisles.
Like a brick,
so we are setting the right combination here. Let's see how it goes. But doesn't it have to be equal on both the sides so that when she walks, it looks more symmetrical? Like 4-4 instead of 4-3?
Yeah, we will have more chair here.
Ah, okay.
No, it doesn't matter. Really.
Doesn't matter? Okay.
No.
You're
but
the
you see the, you'll be...
Oh yeah.
Standing there.
Mhm.
So we have more place this way.
Ah, okay. Even though we have plenty of people and my brother is also going to be joining in very soon and we are doing everything to make sure Papa doesn't work all that much, but he's a very difficult person to control in that sense. He cannot just sit idle and watch things being done around him, and whenever he'll tell him that Papa you should not lift this or do this, then he'll be like, you think I'm old? So we can't really say much about it now. It is quite windy today, which is actually a good thing because otherwise it's hot because of the sun. But the problem it is creating is, I just noticed in the drone shot, the backdrop that we put for interview and everything is getting blown away. So we probably might have to put some kind of a weight on this surface so it's not flying behind us when we have guests here.
We can put those chairs on the back, just two chairs.
Yeah, it's a good idea, but don't you think it would look a little ugly on the drone?
Sandbags were very pretty looking.
Yeah, but sandbag will have like a smaller print.
Do you have a sandbag in your car? Because I don't have a...
We have sandbag sitting down, but we need to put some sand in it.
Then that is a bag, then that is not a sandbag.
Okay, let's try with that. Sandbag.
Is it Christmas?
I don't know how I wrapped it. Whatever. I didn't peek. That look like that work. I think it's working pretty well and the presence is fairly minimal, and we'll just put one more hair in the corner. But Guillaume says after 2 p.m. there's gonna be no wind anyways. But as you know, we believe in better safe than sorry. But I'm really happy. It's sunny, it's nice, and I really hope it remains this way throughout the day so the guests can enjoy the weather and the outside wedding. Now we're also waiting for the DJ to come and start the setup here in the tent. Look like Papa and Guillaume are using their handyman skills to make sure that everything is perfectly aligned. They put a rope like how you would generally in construction to make sure the brick wall is perfectly aligned. And okay, so Papa, we are doing like in a fashion where the number of chairs is increasing to make it look semicircular.
Yeah.
Very nice.
And perfectly aligned.
Yes.
To the center of the hotel.
Okay, so everyone can have like proper view.
Yeah, proper
okay.
view.
Okay.
And hopefully no one will be in, the front that make it like
overlap or block the view.
Yeah, or block the view.
Okay. Make sense. All right, Mr. YouTuber.
Oh, yeah.
Welcome. How are you, sir?
Good. How are you? How's it going?
All good. We are running a little late.
Eh?
No. You don't need to put a mask anywhere.
Good, nice.
In the open. Okay, so they are finalizing the setup for the chair.
Okay,
perfect.
Gimbal.
Thank you
Whatever
so much.
You
oh, this is the action
GoPro,
camera.
Yeah.
Let's go and set up the photo booth. Now I need to explain him exactly what his responsibilities are for today. So when the guests come, they will be coming there from the welcome area. And after that, they'll walk down this staircase and they will come here, and you need to request them for a picture on the Polaroid camera right here, and once the picture is printed, it will be put here.
Where's the camera?
The camera is right here. I'm not sure where it is. Should be right here, but we need to put this back in place because we put it here because there were chances of rain. Okay, let's get started with that.
So put it back where?
Here. Okay, come. You need to hold this, otherwise it will fall.
Yeah, we should have started it at least a month before wedding, but no problem.
Oh, nee. It's too heavy, you can't do it alone. You can, but you should not. 1, 2, 3, go. Okay, let me put these
yeah.
so that it doesn't trip. We need to bring this also a little ahead.
This, guys, is a gift box.
Okay, the flower just came off.
Donation box?
No, this is not donation box. This is wedding gift. A lot of people here also give cash in case they didn't get any time to buy gift.
The speech.
Speech?
Yeah, the speech. The bride, the father bride speech.
So you're not giving that speech?
No, you're gonna get it.
Why? I'm doing my own speech. And I haven't written it yet.
I never did it. That's why I asked you, but it's a joke.
This is first time for me too.
It's first time, huh?
Yeah. Even I'm having
a
hard time.
I never saw it. I didn't know. I didn't went to marriage really often. I never saw it. When she asked me for that, I said, no, I can't. It seems that I have no choice.
You done with your speech?
What?
Your speech?
Yeah.
Have you written it?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. I haven't started it even.
No?
So now I have set up the tripods here, not set up, actually placed exactly where they will be, because I need the permission from Francesca that they can be here in case they are not blocking anything. And as you can see, the altar design has begun. Mr. Gigi's on the job and Francesca is helping guide exactly what is to be done. And Papa? Question.
Yeah, go
question.
Ahead.
You were discussing something about languages here, like speaking a few words.
Yeah.
So the last three sentences of my vows are going to be in French.
Really? Wow.
Yes, especially for grandma.
Wow.
Yeah, I need to practice my accent. I'll go and I'll rehearse with Minel before. So French, Francais for sure.
Well, my speech we is in both languages, French and English.
Oh, awesome.
Get by the way, we were discussing hairstyles, so...
Oh. Yeah!
This is what...
Oh, okay, well, is that enough? When I met Sandra's mother, I was 16. And when I go for the weekend to sleep at their mom's house, in the morning she came over and she taught. She took on a pillow, like, grabbed like, you know, a bunch of hair. I was 16.
Oh, you were looking
16? Oh, that early?
I was 16.
Oh, okay.
So... I knew already when I was young that I'm gonna be like this.
Yeah. But it's okay, Papa, with black that you wear, and you got a pretty badass look anyway.
Yeah, no, it's not black, mine is blue.
What? No, I'm talking about t-shirt.
Oh, okay. My t-shirt.
And you know, Papa, you both of you have something in common.
Yeah.
He's also colorblind.
Oh, really?
Yeah, partially colorblind.
Do you
colorblind.
Have only one good height?
Huh? One good what?
Yeah,
I no, my vision is 20/20.
Okay, not
but
me.
Like no, but like color
you cannot differentiate.
Okay. Like for example, purple and all, no. Blue, you know?
Yeah, me. No purple as well.
Me.
Yeah.
And now we're just opening up the tent so that the guests can see the whole area whenever they come. Final touches are being made and I think we're good to leave soon. Now only just about a little work remains, so we are leaving back for the hotel because everybody has to get ready also. It's like about 10:30 in the morning. And Papa, Angad with two big gensets gonna be at the hotel in about 1 hour. He's left from Ottawa and then he will directly coordinate with you about making sure the power setup is enough for DJ and nothing goes down. DJ is bringing his own generator also.
Oh, okay.
Because there's a power supply problem here. They are not designed for huge consumption, which we will need. But I think we are good to go to the hotel. And now we head back to hotel where my room will be set up for everyone to get ready. That is why I booked a suite, even though it's not that big. We have a nice living area. Hmm. Everyone after taking shower need to come there. Your tuxedos is gonna be there. At this point in time in bride's room, there is so much makeup everywhere, hair stylist. So many people around, you know, all the beautiful, cute, good smelling stuff, decorations and all that. But in my room, you will see all sorts of equipment here and most of it is already gone because the videographers have primarily taken it.